Buenos dias and welcome back to another video, my friends. I hope that you're staying healthy and I hope that you're staying safe wherever you are in the world. Today on the channel, I want to talk about how to use auto exposure bracketing on the Canon EOS R6. So what auto exposure bracketing allows you to do on the Canon EOS R6 is to take consecutive shots, some underexposed, some overexposed, and one exposed to your liking in the center, and allows you then choice. That means that in any specific type of shooting, you can use one that's a little bit underexposed or one that's a little bit overexposed, or you can use the one that you shot that is in the middle, or you can combine them all in post to get the best of all the worlds, under, over, and right on. So some use cases for this would be a scene where you have varying light in different places. For example, I'm backlit right now, so the foreground here, the foreground element, is probably in the dark. So I would have to change my exposure. In this case, I'm going to change my aperture, and I'm going to get a little bit more in the light here. For the mid shot, I might shoot something like this. Oh, these flies. The mid shot, I might shoot something like this to get kind of the mid ground. And then obviously I want to expose for the background. So this is where auto exposure bracketing comes into play. You can set 3 consecutive shots or 5 consecutive shots to go off that are underexposed and overexposed, and be able to select from those images like I mentioned before, or utilize them all and blend them in post. Now let's get into setting up the camera for auto exposure bracketing. Let's first go to the orange menu or the 5th menu over and go into page 1. And let's talk about what we want to set up. So you're going to see exposure level increments. You can leave those at whatever you want, at either a third of a stop or a half stop. ISO speed setting increments, a third or again a half. I just leave them at a third. Speed from metering and ISO auto, I just leave that as auto. And here's where I do make some changes. I like to change bracketing auto cancel to on, the on position. What this allows you to do is it allows the camera to go ahead and clear all settings for auto exposure bracketing when the camera is shut off. Otherwise, when you shut it off and turn it back on, it will stay on and be available to you. And sometimes, or more often than not, you're not going to want to use auto exposure bracketing. Okay, the next thing that you want to do is set the bracketing sequence. And this just means the sequence by which the images are going to be shot, whether you want the underexposed one first or the overexposed one first or the neutral image first. I just choose -0+, which just means underexposed, a proper exposure, and then overexposed. Next, you're going to select the number of bracketed shots. I typically use 3, but you can use 5, 7. You select that for yourself. And then finally, I just leave safety shift in the off position. Now let's go into the red menu or the shoot menu of the camera and select the 2nd page. First line is auto exposure bracketing, or AEB. Here you would simply select whether you want 1 stop, 2 stops, or 3 stops from lightness to darkness in the exposures. And another tip for you would be to be mindful of whether you're shooting RAW, JPEG, or a combination of the two. This just allows you how much flexibility you're gonna have in post. Speaking of post, let's get in the editing suite and start editing some of the images that we took here today at the Nature Preserve. Hey, 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 fancy meeting you here. Let's jump right into Lightroom. So now the purpose of the Lightroom piece of this tutorial is to essentially show you kind of the dark slide or the dark image, the middle ground image, and then the highlight driven image. So let's take a look at this first image here of this flowering plant. What you have here is the darker side of the image, the middle ground, and then finally the lighter side of the image. Let's go to the next set. Again, very more than likely we're clipping there in the blacks or in the darker side of the image, kind of a middle ground, and we're getting some flares there and some little bit of ghosting, and then kind of blown out skies on the highlight side of the image. And of course, the last one here, we have the darker side, the mid ground or the middle ground of the light, and then a little bit more highlights on this image. So let's just show you the process, and then I'll show you all the images after they've been blended. Now, the one thing that I did want to state that I stated out in the field was that you could take any one of these images, for example, this center image or this middle ground image of this flowering plant, and just edit it and not worry about necessarily blending all of the images. You have choices, and that is when you want to utilize auto exposure bracketing out in the field, is if maybe you're in a rush and you're not sure what exactly the settings need to be. So get your camera straight, make sure that you've got the exposure right, and then click off the three auto exposure bracketing images, and that way you have one that's underexposed and one that's overexposed in a snap versus having to do it manually. But again, you can absolutely do it manually, no problem there. But again, in kind of high speed situations where the image is fairly static, you know that event isn't gonna last that long, that AEB might be of service to you or of some kind of help to that process and actually save you and have an underexposed and an overexposed image for you to choose from. Okay, but in this case, we're gonna go ahead and blend these images. So I'm gonna take all three of these images, for example. I'm gonna come up here to the photo tab and click on photo merge and click on HDR. We're gonna leave it on high. All the settings are actually fine there. So now what you see in theory is the best of the dark pixels, the very highlighted pixels, and obviously the middle ground pixels. So let's go ahead and merge this. And in Lightroom, it'll pop up in your main selection of images. Now let's compare the histogram to all four images and see if Lightroom was able to blend correctly, and does the image actually look good or pleasing to your eye in terms of the right exposure. So let's look at the first one, which was the darker image. Now let's look at the second one, which was kind of the middle ground. Now let's take a look at the last image, which is the exposed more for highlights. And then finally, let's take a look at the blended image, which now shows that the histogram is more centered from left to right. Nothing is overexposed, nothing is underexposed, and it is trending towards an even kind of nice little U towards the center of the histogram. Now let's quickly take a look at the next set of image, the underexposed image, the neutral image, and the highlighted images, or the one that was exposed for highlights. And then finally, let's take a look at the histogram for the blended image. And as you can see, once again, what we have there is a fairly even photo. However, it is trending towards the highlights on the right side of the histogram, but that's okay. You can work with it. Again, these are still raw images. I have not edited these whatsoever. Now let's take a look at the last set of images, the one that was exposed for more darkness, neutral, and highlights. And then finally, let's take a look at the blended image histogram. And again, what Lightroom is trying to do here is not clip on the darks or the lights, but try to bring them in off of those edges on the sides. Alrighty, that's how you set up, shoot, and edit auto exposure bracketed images on the Canon EOS R6. Use it to your advantage, go out and practice, and you'll know when you might want to use it in your workflow when you're out shooting photography. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. I would appreciate it more than you know. I would also appreciate if you ring that bell to notify you of new videos when they are released. Like this video, it means more than you know. I would really appreciate it. And please comment down below. I'd love to chat with you. All right, until the next one, I love y'all. Peace.